Yeah, man, I put those bread ties on there to hold them together so they wouldn't get separated on the way up here. I think those might be those trash bag ties.
I was gonna say, you know, I used to use them kids' fuzzy sticks.
Yeah.
Art pieces.
Yeah.
Pipe
yeah,
ones.
Yeah, yeah.
On everything.
Yeah, those things were good. But these are brand new reels. Never been used. They're, you've never used one like this, probably, have you?
What do you mean?
It's a Carbon X made by PC Fun.
I know I haven't. I got a Mitchell reel about that size, about the only thing close I've ever used.
Well, this is a 500 series Carbon X. Company's name is PC Fun, and I mean, I have not found a better reel for this price range is what this one is right here.
And it looks cool as all get out.
Well, it is, and it's got such a smooth little drag, and for these trout and using like 4 and 6 pound line, it's awesome. And crappie fishing too. Okay. Uh-oh. Don't get it all scratched up already, Aaron. Golly.
Hit right on the handle, we're lucky.
Just scuff it all up, my brand new stuff. I bought these just so we could go trout fishing. Man, that's a big old mountain right over there. I think my bag of goodies is in this big camper we got to stay in. That's still, even though it's small, still a pretty neat little camper.
Yeah.
Well, how long is it?
12 foot.
12 foot. So it's big enough to sleep in. We got all our gear in here for elk hunting.
A kitchen.
And, yeah, this is what I like, is the kitchen is outside.
I need to find something to dump this stuff in where we can kind of sort through.
I've got a little fanny pack I'm going to carry with me, but I don't know if it'll fit all in there. But yeah, this
I'll
is awesome.
You just my pocket once I get.
Flip this up. You got a microwave, a little refrigerator. You got a little sink. You got speakers from stereo. Here's your little stove. It's awesome little camper. It serves its purpose. If you can't tell, we're headed elk hunting, not fishing. But we're going to fish for a few hours. Oh, I'm talking to myself. We're going to fish for a few hours and see if we can't catch us some of these world-class trout up here in this Rio Grande River.
One thing I really know about trout is they're slimy and they're hard to hold on to.
You ain't kidding. It's like catching a big shad or something. We'll get these reels pulled up. We're going to put 6 pound on this first. If we can't catch nothing with 6 pound, I guess we go to 4, huh? Try that. Is that enough?
Work.
Looks good. Yeah. Got your teeth?
I don't use my teeth on that stuff. I got old chompers.
Yeah, mine too. All right, now we need to find a good plug to put on these things. We're going to get this thing started. Just to give somebody a little bit of history, I'm 50 years old and I am a beginner trout fisherman. If you hadn't seen my other video I did a couple weeks ago, I went to Oklahoma and I caught several trout on this little spinner right here. This little bitty rooster tail. And so I've still got it rigged up and we're going to give it another shot. See if it works in this river, which is the Rio Grande River running through Colorado. And something that I got a little different is I've got a little swivel on it this time. Because last time that thing twisted my line up something terrible. So I got a little swivel on there. I don't know if I'm going to leave it on there. I'm going to start out with it. If it just doesn't work out, I'll take it off. But we're going to get started. I got my buddy Aaron with me. And he'll be down here in a minute. And we're going to try to beat the britches off him if we can. But him and I are going elk hunting. It's the last week of August. September comes down this weekend and the first weekend of September and we're going elk hunting, so we're just working our way up through Colorado and we're going to fish our way up till we get to where we're elk hunting. So hopefully we're going to stop at several different places and I hope we got elk to show you, which I'm going to try to film some elk hunting, but I hope I got some trout to show you in this one. Yeah, we got to get out where it's a little deeper. It's pretty neat. Somebody has built a little like an area where you could put your trout in to take pictures. Like a little, what do we call this? Fish basket made out of rocks.
Big fish basket. I'd say down there in that corner, right for them rocks.
Right over here?
Yeah.
Or these bigger boulders are. Let's see how cold this water is. Hey, this is why you bring your sneakers you had since 1985 right here. So you can walk in this river. There's a boat yonder. And they got swimming trunks on, man. It's freaking cold. Swimsuits. Catch one out of them rocks right there. Them gals right there is tough now. I'm not gonna get no deeper than my kneecaps. Uh-oh. I forgot how to throw this thing. They like crappie fishing where you drop straight down. I'm already backlashed. All right, who's gonna be the first one to catch one? We actually just trying to catch big ones, right? And what I'm gonna try to do, something I learned while I was in Oklahoma fishing the other day, is that those fish like to be around these bigger boulders, kind of on the back side of them, in this little slacker water. They'll kind of hide right there where that current breaks over. And if you can find a little deeper area that makes like a, oh, I don't know if you call it a seam or what, but they'll get in that too. I'm gonna have to have. Here they come. I may have made my little leader too long. You what? You had a bite? Which way do I need to go to get out of y'all's way?
That's a iffy question.
I sure hate for you to knock me down in this cold water.
Very true.
Y'all a lot tougher than me being in swimsuits and this stuff.
It feels pretty good.
It's pretty cold to me.
Cold play.
We're from East Texas. It's been hot. This is cool weather up here.
Very true.
You too. Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Right behind that, right beside that big one.
That big one, right, kind of in front of it or behind it?
Right between you and I, on the end of it. I'm going to go back to it, but I'm going to give it a
I don't know if that's a rock. I think it was. You going down? Is it deeper over there? Uh-oh. You see some over there? Yeah. Supposedly, there's some really big trout in this Rio Grande River up in through here. Biggest I caught in Oklahoma was probably, I think, around 15 inches or so. So we're going to try to top that. And all I caught there was rainbows. I think there's some really big brown trout and some cutthroats, and I think there's a tiger trout I think I saw on the brochure. So we hadn't committed ourselves to learning how to fly fish yet. Well, hopefully that's coming pretty soon. You can hang this thing up in these rocks for sure. I need some line with more visibility, I think, because my old eyes can't hardly see it. I think I'm going to change spots. Move up a little farther into some slacker water and see what happens. Okay, so something that just happened here, right in this swift water, I just scared out a fish that was probably 14 inches long. I didn't even see it. I got here close to it and it took off. So, that's interesting. I'm just gonna have to be trying all over, I guess. They're not really, I didn't expect to see one out in the open flat like that. Dude, there's a good one right here, and another one is as big as that, and then that freaking thing we just saw over there in that little creek.
Really?
Yeah. The one that followed me was that big. This one is about, I don't know, he's 14, 15 inches. And he's sitting, he's facing that way. That's why he can't see me. I'm going to have to find me something else to get him. But one knocked the snot out of it in there, man. It must have got wise to it or something. That one's just staying right there behind a little rock. I can come right by him, he don't do anything. Went right under him that time, he didn't do nothing. Nope. Let's get a crawdad after him.
I don't know what's done with it. Looks like a damn scorpion sting at home.
It hurts, huh? Doing good. He's back in the same spot. There's another one. I see another one. They're all right here hanging in this. They're not running after this thing.
You try drifting back into them?
That's what I'm doing. Going right in their face. Oh, he took off. I hit him with it. I wonder if I need something a little less flashy. You see two of them? Yeah, there was at least three right here, but I spooked them out of here now, I guess. I'm sure they're like anything else, they'll bite later. Whatever, they ain't liking it yet, that's for sure. I got rocks all in my shoe. One hit it? There were several good ones in that little back there, but Only the one chased it. I had one hit it, but I don't know if I didn't run into him. Or, you know what I mean? I might have hit him. Well, that's how those in Oklahoma were, man. They were hitting like crazy. There's ain't no telling how many I missed for all that I caught, you know. Do what? Pretty deep. I just saw one hit the top of the water. You see that? It was right out there to the right of them big boulders in front of you. It's what?
The water's not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Like rapids?
Or cold.
Oh, no. I'm used to it now. It feels good. It's kind of chilly there at the beginning. Right now, we just need one. No matter what size he is. There he is.
Really?
That's that one that I told you I saw feeding on top, I bet you. That's a good one too, buddy.
You got your camera on?
I got it going.
Cool.
Yeah, hey, that's one in brown.
Is it really?
Yes, sir, a good one too, man. If hopefully we can land this thing without them.
I got one swimming past me right now.
Check this out. If I don't lose him with them darn barbless hooks. Oh, big, come here. Check this out. Look at the colors on that thing. That may be, is that, I don't know what that is. I guess it's a brown. Hey, that sucker got some teeth in there. Is that a tiger one? Oh, he broke my line. That's stupid. Throwing that little stupid, pulling on that 6-pound line. He had teeth all in his mouth.
Well, I mean, the trout do.
Do they?
Oh, you ought to see them trout that they raise in like them farms. Them suckers eat the tails off the other trout.
Dang, that was a good one.
Yeah, he was.
All right, y'all, man. Dadgummit, I lost that dang spinner. I lost my big fish. I don't know what kind it was. I think it was a tiger trout. It had red dots on it, kind of brownish, goldish with red dots. And I got a crappie jig. We're going to throw it out there. We don't have no more little spinners. How stupid is that to come out without enough fish bait?
You sure you don't want one of these bigger ones?
No, not yet. If you start whacking them on it, I will. Dang, that's the biggest I've ever... I ain't never seen one like that before. And I'd seen that thing surface, or I saw one surface anyway. I don't know if it was that fish. But I saw one surface and I threw over there and smack, boy. This thing may be too green. This water's so clear. I don't know if they like chartreuse. I did catch my first one in Oklahoma on this, but then I didn't catch no more, and so I changed to that little spinner and just went to blasting on them things. I'd put me a buzz bait on out here. I know it, dadgum, it's beautiful. I've never seen anything like that before. I never expected to hang one like that, that had those colors like that. I learned something though. You see them little, you see them come up and nip the top, you better chunk over there. Well, what's nuts is he wasn't behind no big rock or anything. Yeah, and he hadn't made it back yet. Uh-oh, I hung in a brush pile somebody put out. You see a good one? I hadn't seen any more on this side. guessing that this chartreuse jig doesn't look like anything natural floating down a river. Oh, because nothing's hit it yet. Crazy, the wind is blowing upriver. It makes your bait kind of do funky stuff. Yeah. Got him? Good one?
No.
How big is it? Oh, he's not bad. What is it? What kind is it? Can you tell? It's a rainbow?
Yeah.
Was that on the big spinner? They're slippery little dudes. Come this way a little. Is a little guy?
Yeah, probably 10 inches long.
10 inches?
Huh?
10 inches?
Maybe a little longer.
Oh, that's that. Oh, man. Boy, we sure are good at making video. We can't even hang on to one long enough. It did.
As soon as it
Chartreuse hair jig ain't doing much good. Lost my lucky spinner. Thank you. You missed one? One thing about them, they just ain't all over the place. I gotta find something else. Unless I'm just not throwing around the fish. It looks like a mayfly would look. Flies up here in August. No, I saw more back there.
Huh?
I saw more back there.
Yeah.
There's got to be another stretch where there's more though. This is a deep little hole right here. That's how that was earlier. I was seeing them just sitting there, but I couldn't get them to bite anything. a big one? Yes. Real big. He's headed down river. Woo, son. Come here, baby. Don't you come off. Come here, I have to get you. You're going to come take a picture if I can get him landed. Whoa! No, you got to get a picture first. Woo, son. I'm surprised he ain't jumping. Huh? Dang. I'm wearing him down. I'll get my picture if I can catch him. It's the same kind as I had. And they don't give up either. That sucker's turning me circles. I'm gonna get him in this slack water here. I got him. Good God. Oh man, that's a good one right there. That's one of them tigers, isn't it?
I don't know, get in here. Yeah, that'll work.
All right, hurry up and get this rascal back in the water. Is that one of them tiger stripe ones?
I don't know.
I don't think I even got the dang release on camera, I don't know. Dang, that thumb cripple was strong. That fish bit this little black and yellow crappie jig. It looks like a little bumblebee. Just kind of throwing it up and letting it drift back with the current. And see if we can't get another one. I tell you what, this is a workout on you working through these rocks with tennis shoes on. I might have to get me some different footwear for this. Man, that was a strong fish. Took off when it hit it too, man, up the river. And it wasn't in no dang protected spot either like I had thought. I thought I might catch them around some big boulders or something, man. It was just kind of out in the flat current area there. Eat the snot out of it. Man, I never knew how fun trout fishing was until recently. All my life I've been fishing and never had done any of this. And just being out in the mountains and getting to wade around in a river, man, I tell you, it's something I'd advise everybody to do if you're a fisherman, even if you're not. it's very relaxing. You don't have to have expensive equipment. I mean, the reel right here, it's a PC Fun Carbon X 500 series reel. It's like, I think they're $80-something, and there's always discounts. As a matter of fact, there's a discount in my description. I want to put a code in there. It's catch15, and it'll get you an extra 15% off. So if you use that, that'll help me and help, you know, be able to bring you hopefully some good fishing and maybe teach you how to catch a few more. You know, more videos I can make and more information I can share with people, maybe they can get out and catch some and everybody can enjoy it. So now I need to catch a big old rainbow or something like that. I'm gonna look, I don't know. I think that one was a tiger striped one. Let's see. No, it wasn't a tiger trout. It had red spots on it. Maybe it was a brown trout. I think it was a brown trout. That's what that was right there, I think. I'm gonna carry this with me so I can identify them. If that was a brown trout, that's exactly what I caught before, the one that I had up and it broke my string. I'm curious as to why these couple fish that I've hung aren't jumping. It's the last week of August. You'd think they'd be jumping out of the water. Just a couple weeks ago, the ones I caught in Oklahoma, man, they jump as soon as you get a hold of them. another kayaker down there. I don't know if y'all can see that mountain. Man, it's beautiful. Gotta be a fish in these rocks. Every now and then we get one.
Nice. Beautiful day.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I got rocks killing my feet. All that gravel. Made like panning for gold with my tennis shoes. Thank you. Yeah, that's what I was doing. I was painting for gold with mine right there a while ago. Do what?
I didn't see him. I could get up in there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's because of the angle of the sun or what. You want to ease down and go up yonder? Get in the truck?
Huh?
You want to get in the truck and go up the road?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do that. All right, it says, fishing by artificial flies, lures only, limit 2 brown trout, 12 inches or smaller. Rainbow trout must be immediately returned back to the water.
What is it?
Rainbow's got to be immediately put back. Same regulations. Did you lock that door over there?
Do what? You
probably ought to lock them here. It would have been cool to see them old steam engines going on these old railroad tracks back in the old days. There's all kinds of old, gold mining camps and stuff set up down through these mountains along these rivers. That's pretty cool to think about. Oh, you chiggers, don't you get on me. Oh. All right. Got our little bumblebee plug. Windy down in here. Couple big old boulders down in there. Come on, big trouts. You hit them big boulders, it feel like a bite. That bait drifting out across there. I like this up here because it's narrower, smaller. Those fish ain't got as much area to be in. Maybe it'll be easier to find them and catch them. I'm up on top of the water over there, across on the other side of the river. Golly, the water's colder up here too. Deeper. He's over there. Closer to the bank. Ooh, I had a rock bite or something. There was something. surfaced over there, though. Gotta be a nest of them things in here somewhere. hot down in here. My arms are getting sunburned. There he is. Another good one. Big one. It's a big old rainbow.
Really?
Yeah. Oh. Look at this thing. How big that is?
Yeah,
it's
bigger than one I had by a long shot.
Big old thing, man.
Mine was 12, 13 inches maybe.
This one's probably 16. Hey. Awesome fish. Oh, look at that. Awesome. I mean, look at this on my arm. That thing may be 18 inches. Get back in here. That thing's big.
Still using that black jig?
That little bumblebee looking thing?
Yeah.
Woo! That's a, had to be 18 inches, I bet. He wasn't as strong as that brown, those browns I had. Sure was big though. Looked like probably an older fish. Oh, I just missed another one. Or he missed me. No. It's just a crappie jig. Dang. Sucker was long, man.
That little rainbow is pretty.
Yeah, that was right there. Big old long thing. Oh yeah?
Oh yeah. He's laying right in front of the
clock. We moved up about, or I say up, down, up. I guess we're up because the river, we went up current. I'm gonna say 6 miles or so.
And right across the top of it.
And the river, as you can tell, got a whole lot narrower. It's deeper out there, but it's a whole lot narrower, and it's a lot, you know, it's gonna pack the trout into a smaller area, which is kind of good for us since we don't know what we're doing.
Not interested. I'm bouncing off of it like
on a bed. Oh, really? Like a bass on the bed, huh?
Water.
Man, it's hot. Big old long one?
Yeah. They don't want no part of this.
Yeah, I think you got to throw it in front of a bunch of them.
Makes you want to tie something else on.
Well, you caught that one. So, just from my short experience of being here just a couple hours, what I gather is that this Rio Grande River up here in this part of Colorado is a trophy trout fishery, maybe. And maybe not as many numbers as other places, but when you catch one, it's a good one. Oh, I bet, you know, if you wanted to come to catch a big trout, I think this would probably be one of the areas to be looking at. And we're here at the last part of August. I mean, this is the last few days of August. I think it's the 28th or 9th. And there's nobody here. I mean, there's a couple people fishing down the river, but not many. And the weather's beautiful. It's the 29th. Weather is beautiful, so if you're a trout fisherman and wanna catch a trophy trout or maybe even get out of the Texas heat or wherever you live in the heat, this is the place to come. One of many, I'm sure, but any old guy like me can catch them. Anybody can.
Well, I need to cast like right here so you can get close to it.
The one right there in front of you?
No.
To the left?
Yep.
Yeah. Man, dude, I wish we could have got a picture. We were always too far away. Yeah, and it's deeper. You talking about that boulder I see out there?
Huh?
That boulder I see?
Well, there's one in the water.
Yeah.
That's right by that thing right
there. That red looking one right there to the left of there? Or the dark one? The dark one or these red ones? Oh yeah, you talking about over there?
Yeah, just past where you just...
Yeah, I can't reach that far. You saw one come up in there?
Twice. Right by that big, right by the rock in the water.
Did you hang one and lose one in here?
Yeah, right there. There's another little, looks like another little rainbow. It's little. I don't think they like the spinner or something. I don't know.
I don't think they like much of nothing we got. Back to that hole where I caught that good one and worked my way back down. I think it's a lot deeper in there, and that sure was a lot bigger fish. All right, we're back in that spot again. Any of you seasoned trout fishermen know that there's a deeper hole like this a better area for catching big ones? That sure was a whole lot bigger than anything I've caught. I'd appreciate any advice you can share. Appreciate any advice you can share. Breezy. Wind thing's helping in here.